swear it's not my fart. I swear. Maybe so. But hey,
what you doing with all that? Let me touch it.
Let me feel.
She says mine, so I smack it when I freak in the bed, but innocent in public.
Wish you watch it.
She be hearing night, but still she love me.
Hey, water Fiji hold his chin while he in the mirror, cause he know it's conceited. Possessive with that, piece.
Hey y'all, it's me back again with another video. It's Symone Elon. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe. Thank you. All right, y'all, we back. We back with another Symone Talk. Symone Talk. This time, it's college edition. So, yes. So, everybody always asks me, y'all, why you don't have no roommate? Where did your roommate go? Why did they leave? What did you do, Symone? What did you do? I didn't do nothing. I swear to God, y'all. I promise. So, today, we're going to talk about, why do my roommates always leave me? I don't know. I swear to God, let me tell y'all. I swear to God, I don't know, y'all. Like, for real, like, we'll talk, bro. We'll talk. So, if y'all don't know, like, if y'all don't have me on social media, like Snapchat, y'all could go add me in my intro. Yeah. So, if y'all don't have me on Snapchat, y'all need to add me for real because, like, I always post. Like, every year, maybe multiple times a year, I will post. No roommate again. No roommate again. It doesn't matter what school I am, what grade I am. My roommates always leave me, but I swear it's not my fault. I swear. Maybe so, but not. Okay, let me tell y'all. Okay, so I had five roommates out of 3 years in college. That's bad. I know, right? I'm sorry. Okay, let me talk. All right, so the first roommate,
I'll call her Tara, okay?
So Tara, my freshman year, she was my very first roommate. And this girl, she was more excited than me. Like, you know me, my freshman year, I was really scared, nervous. And, like, I was excited, but I was really scared to go to college. But this girl, she found me off of Facebook, started texting me, like, oh, what's your colors going to be? I'm your roommate. Yeah, it's going to be so exciting. I can't wait. You know what I'm saying? Like, she more excited than me. So, my freshman year and my sophomore year, I went to Pittsburgh State. And then my junior year, which is this year, I transferred to UCM. So this girl more excited than me to go to Penn State. So we all cool, you know what I'm saying? Like I get to my room, everything's all cool. She really was cool. Like she said, if anything happened, you could just call me, I'll pick you up, blah, blah, blah. I remember that. We add each other on social media, like Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, and stuff like that. Everything was real cool. And then one day, it was like 5 days later, legit. 5 days later, the fifth day of school.
She's like,
college is not for me. I think I'm gonna drop out. I said, girl, what? Drop out on the fifth day of school? Girl, what are you talking about? Like, it's legit the only fifth day of school. Like, I know college ain't for everybody. I'm my mama. College ain't for everybody, but college gonna be for me. I'm my mama. College gonna be for me. But, girl, how you don't know college is not for you in 5 days? Not even a whole semester. 5 days. Girl, stop playing. Like, what? She said, yeah, I'm gonna drop out. I'm gonna think about doing homeschool. I was like, what about that money? She was like, well, I'm a foster student, so college was free anyways. Girl, you still waste all that money. Like, for real. Like, no, girl. Like, what? And she was not playing. Like, she legit told our RA that day or the next day or whatever. And then that weekend, she was gone. Like, real talk. She was gone. And that's crazy. But, like, she was gone. She packed all her stuff and everything. So, I was by myself for 3 weeks, y'all. I hated being by myself. Like, first of all, I'm not even used to living with people. I'm used to living with my mama, my sister, my brother, my daddy, and my, yeah, that's it, you feel me? Me and my sister, we shared room, like, all of our lives, but the last 2 years, while I was in high school, she was in college. So I was used to, like, just living without her, like, in my room, you know what I'm saying? I was just used to not sharing rooms. But I wasn't used to not being with my family, though. I was definitely a little homesick, because, you know, my freshman year. But I'm saying, like, I did not like living by myself my freshman year. My first semester, I did not like living by myself. It was just so lonely. And it was just like, I always got locked out. I always forget my key. I'm like, I hate it. And I'm pretty sure that Tara deleted me off of social media. Don't know why. A little weird. My daddy said maybe because she didn't want it. She wanted to delete everything off from that school. She don't delete everything from that school. So she low-key had a problem with me, but I ain't tripping. So my close friend at the time, moved in with me, which was my second roommate, which was my crazy ex-roommate. Y'all know the video, y'all know the vibes, y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. Speaking of that, let me just say right here, y'all. That video, my crazy ex-roommate, the story time, was my second YouTube video, and it had, guess how many views, y'all? Guess how many views I got right now? I got 543 views. Like, what the heck, bro? That mug had hella clout. Like, y'all, I swear to God, that mug had hella clout. Like, she watched the video, first of all. She started trying to talk stuff under the comments. And then I was like, thank you for the clout. She was trying to talk stuff. This boy commented under the video. It was a random person. It was like, oh, you talking about that whole Miranda? I know exactly who you talking about. Not that I said her name. Okay. I was weak. I said, damn, she getting around, huh? Put her on Snapchat. I still have her on Snapchat this time. This girl was like a porn star or something. And she just posted videos of her naked and just pictures and stuff. So I was screen recording it, y'all. I was being messy. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I was being messy. I ain't messy no more, y'all. But y'all know for real. So I screen recorded her videos of her like doing that nasty stuff. Posted it on my Snapchat. I was like, y'all, this is the roommate I was talking about. Go watch my video. That got more clout. You feel me? She recorded my video and put it on her Snapchat and was like, she talking about me. She made a whole 10-minute video about me. Yes, I sure did. Like, I ain't nobody's press. You feel me? I wasn't pressed or nothing because that was a long time ago. I just wanted, you know, get some laughs, make a video. I didn't know it was going to get big like that. I didn't know. But sure did. Y'all can keep watching it. Cause it's definitely funny. Y'all won't miss out. Anyways. So yeah, let's talk about the rundown about her. We call her M in the video. Her real name Miranda. I really don't care no more. She married her sugar daddy for real. If you want to be honest, she really married her sugar daddy. That nigga like in the 30s and shit. Anyways, not my business. Let me just say the reason why she moved out. She moved in. Like the end of September and moved out like the beginning of December because it was like before Christmas break. So that was like, I don't know how, you know. So that's how long she stayed. And we stopped like being cool around Halloween time because she left me at a frat party, which was fake. We already know that. So yeah, like, I remember after she saw me, like after she moved out, she got her own apartment. That's why after she moved out, she was like, hey, Ruby. Oh my gosh, Ruby. No, don't touch me. Don't touch me, girl. Don't touch me. I was like, don't touch me. But nah, we ain't cool. We still ain't cool. I don't care about her. I don't follow her. None of that. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's the second roommate, y'all. Second roommate. I'm sorry about my bad days, y'all. I'm taking these nails off of this video. Let me keep it honest. But anyways, so yeah, that's my second roommate. Let me say it. So after she moved, I was cool being by myself freshman year. So the whole spring semester, freshman year, I was by myself and I was happy. I put those bands together. Let me tell y'all. Let me see if I still got a video for my freshman year. I put those bands together. I was not playing. And my room was actually big to put the bands together. Okay, third year, my sophomore year, right? So I'm like, oh, I hope I get a good roommate this year. Yeah. No. She wasn't bad. I ain't go for it like she was bad or nothing. Third roommate, we're gonna call her Sarah. Alright. She was cool or whatever. She transferred from a different school. My room was small sophomore year just because we had a bathroom in our room, so that room was small. So she was on this side, I was on this side. So you know me, I love to sleep, you feel me? And I had late classes, so I was sleeping till like, what, 12, 1, you feel me? I don't know. I would just sleep in. And she had early classes, so she had 8 o'clock a.m. classes. So she would have to go to bed early, and I used to go to bed late. So she'd be like, can you turn the light off? Can we turn the light off? Can you lower your voice? I'm about to go to sleep. Can you turn your music off? Can you put your headphones in? Stuff like that. It was kind of irritating because I just don't like that period. But it wasn't like bad. Like she wasn't tripping about it or nothing. She didn't do too much. You feel me? She just asked me to do it and I would just turn the light off, keep my lamp on. I would, what's that called? Like put my headphones in. That's it. I just don't like doing that. And I was sleeping hella late, like usual. But I guess she didn't like that, like, I would sleep in all the time. So she said, so one day she was like, hey, I'm gonna move out. And I was like, okay. Like, no, for real. Like, I was just used to it. So I was just like, okay, what's going to ask? Why? She was like, just because our schedule is different, our sleeping schedule is different, I don't want to be quiet all the time while you sleeping. So at least she had respect that while I was sleeping till 1 o'clock, she would be quiet. You feel me? She just, I understand, like, I wouldn't want to be quiet all the time because old girl sleeping, I feel you, but sure. I just love to sleep. I'm sorry, my bad. She was like, that, I really wouldn't say my fault. The second roommate, I would say my fault, but you know, I don't care if the second roommate was my fault. First roommate was not my fault. Third roommate was not my fault either. So she moved upstairs to the fourth level to a person that got the same, like, class schedule as her. But each time we see her, we see each other, we're like, hey, girl, how you doing, blah, blah. We still got each other on Snapchat. Everything's still cool. Like I said, not my fault. Okay, next roommate, my fourth roommate. Junior year at UCM. Okay. Oh yeah. So my third roommate, after she moved out in a month, I had the whole rest of the year by myself. I was so happy. Oh my mama, I was so happy. Like, for real. Like, I was trying to put those beds together, but my room was so small, so I couldn't do it. But having my old room and my old bathroom, best thing ever. Alright, fourth roommate, we're gonna call her Shelly. So she was real cool. She was nice. I swear, she was like my best roommate I ever had. So she was real cool. She probably stayed with me for like a month, you know what I'm saying? And we would legit had like genuine conversations. Like, we would talk about random things sometimes. We'd be like, it was like real cool, like real talk. But she was barely there either. She would always like spend the night over at somebody else's house. She was a transfer student as well. I was too. So we was both new to the school. But I already had friends at the school already. She didn't. So she met this new girl. I don't know what her name is. But she was the one that she always was over her house all the time. So I was cool with her sleeping over old girl's house because I had a room by myself, which I love. And at the time, we shared a room. Not shared room, but we shared a bathroom with suite mates. That was my first time ever having suite mates. I did not like having suite mates either. I did not like sharing a bathroom, period. Like, I always have to use the restroom, so I hate have to share the restroom with other people. That's even at home. I wake up. I use the restroom. My brother in the restroom. Like, come on, Trey, get out of the restroom, dang. I gotta pee. Like, that's irritating. Like, I hate using the restroom. I hate sharing the restroom with other people. Anybody. So now I have to share the restroom with three other people. Oh my gosh, that was so annoying. I wake up middle of the night, they taking these long showers and stuff. Early in the morning, they taking these long showers. Like, come on, I gotta get ready for school too. Like, dang. So that's the way. Anyways. So, old girl moved out. Shelly moved out because she went to live with her new friend. I remember she texted me. She was like, hey, I'm going to move out. I'm going to move in with my new friend. That's the person I'm always at her house anyways. Blah, 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 blah. Like, wow, y'all. Like, another roommate is leaving? And it's not my fault at all. I'm trying to tell y'all. It's not my fault. It's not someone's fault. But she was like, yeah, me and my boyfriend broke up. So she was the one that was always over her house anyways. She's my only friend. She's lived down the street. So I'm over her. So I was like, okay. Had the room by myself for like 2 weeks. Then this school get on my nerves. They want to email me, hey, since you ain't got no roommate, we gonna move you down the hallway with somebody else. Are you serious, bro? Like, I got way too much stuff. Like, if y'all know me, I got too much clothes, too much shoes. I got too much stuff. My stuff can barely fit in my mom and my daddy car. So I gotta move all this stuff down the hallway. I don't care if it's down the hallway. Old girl could have moved in with me if you want to give me a new roommate. Like, that's all I gotta care. That's all I gotta say. Like, what? Like, that's made me so mad for real. So I had to get two of my friends to help me move down the hallway. I don't care if it's just down the hallway. Old girl could have moved in with me. So, I had two weeks of that room by myself, moved in with another girl. Fifth roommate, y'all. So, we're gonna call my fifth roommate Lisa. Alright. Lisa, my last roommate. So, I had to move down the hallway with Lisa. She was cool at first, you know what I'm saying? We was real cool or whatever. She said she gonna sleep late. I'm like, all right, bae, I'm gonna sleep late too. You feel me? So, but sometimes she always be like, oh, hey, I'm gonna sleep. You gonna turn the light off, okay? It is hella early. Like, girl, it ain't hella early. It was like 12 o'clock. Like, late for me, it's like 1 o'clock, 1:30. You feel me? 1:30. No, past that. So, yeah. On school day. So, yeah. So, but it didn't really matter because she was, like, gone, like, every weekend. Like, so,
we have my own room again.
And, y'all, the good part was it? We had no sweet mates. I'm my mom. We had no sweet mates. I was so happy. So, they had to share the bathroom with her. So, let me get into it. So, the reason why I think she left, like, real talk, she never really told me why she left. She just packed her bags and left. Like, dead serious. I saw her and watched her pack her bags. Yeah. Anyways, like, I was like, shit, I don't care. You know me, I don't care. I don't care. So, but I think the reason why she left because she would always have to tell me to turn my music down, like in the shower. Like, I'm showering while she's sleeping. She would tell me to turn my music down. And she, I don't know. Like, I really don't know. Like, y'all, it was either my music. She would have to tell me to turn my videos down sometimes. That's it. Tell me to put my headphones in. She would turn the light off. Like, I don't know. Like, I dead ass don't know. Like, I think the only reason why is because the music. Like, I really don't know why anything else. I asked her before too. I was like, was my music too loud in the shower? And she's like, no, you good, no, you good. But sometimes she would knock on the door, hey, can you turn the music down? Like, whatever, you know what I'm saying? But I don't really care because at first it was cool. Like, we would say, hey, we speak to each other, come in the room. Sometimes we have conversations, you know what I'm saying? Like, my Halloween costume, I had a boxer. And I had, she's actually a boxer. So she had those rapid things or whatever. So she let me use it, you know what I'm saying? So she was real cool. Then she just started not speaking. And just started, like, getting a little, not really attitudes because we didn't speak. It was just, I don't know. Like, she was just weird because for that. I feel like she was weird. Because I feel like, and I don't like her. The reason why I don't like her is because if you was going to move out, you could at least told me. You could at least tell me the problem. You could at least spoke what the problem is. If you was real, you would have said, hey, I'm moving out. Just like every single other roommate did, they told me, hey, I'm moving out. And I would be like, okay. They would say a reason. They might not say a reason. She didn't say nothing. She just moved out. That's fake. That's weird for that. Because I would have told you, hey, I'm moving out. I would have told you why. You didn't have to tell me why. You could just say, I'm moving out. That's just it. But she packed her bags. You know, I don't care. So this will happen, right? So she would have leave her little, what's that called? She left her air freshener. Kept that mug. She left her little boxing things. Yup. And she left her little, like a little plant. So guess what I did with that? Throw that stuff away. I was not playing.
For how she would. Knock, knock, knock. Hey, can I get my stuff? No. The heck? I threw that away. Not just like.
But for real, she ain't gonna do that though. But I saw her today. I was like, but the hell out of her. Like, the hell? Like, I be trying so hard, like, to keep it all in. Because I could talk bad. I could have talked bad to her. I was like, hey, right, that I ain't even tripping, you know what I'm saying? I ain't even tripping.
Yeah, like, I just do not like sharing a room with anybody. Any stranger. Like, I'm used to sharing my room with my sister, my family, but a stranger, I don't like looking to the left and seeing a girl I don't know. I swear, I don't like that. I don't like that, y'all. I swear, like, I don't like, hey, can we turn the light off? Hey, I'm trying to go to sleep. Hey, can you turn your music down? Can you lower your voice? Can we turn the light off?
No, I don't like that. I like living by myself, having an own freedom. I can turn the light off when I want to. Keep the light on how long I want to. Listen to my music how loud I want to. Be on the phone as long as I want to. Share the bathroom? No. Use the bathroom whenever I want to. Yes, that's what I like doing. I don't like sharing a room with people, strangers. Since I keep having this bad history, roommates, it's better keep on going. I'm not playing. See you here. More bad roommates, please. Not slay, nah, nah. But see you here. Next year, I'm living in an apartment where there's like four different rooms. And you got like upstairs, downstairs, kitchen, living room, all that stuff. So
I barely gonna see my roommates, but I'm living with my friends, so that's good. We ain't gonna bump heads and all like that. And I never had a black roommate before. It was always white or Hispanic. I don't know if they're racist or white, not slave, but like I said, never had a black roommate before. But I was always a black roommate. Not just like, okay, y'all, for real, okay. So like I was saying, like, y'all get the story. Y'all feel me? Like, I do not like sharing rooms with people, strangers. It was not my fault. Maybe the last one, I don't know. If she had told me what the problem was, then I can figure out if it was my fault or not. So now I'm just guessing, like, oh, maybe because it's this reason she left for me, because that reason. But you know, I don't care. I don't really don't care. People always come in, Symone, what did you do? I ain't do nothing, y'all. I'm trying to let y'all know it's not my fault, okay? Get that now. It's not my fault. Thank you. Thank y'all for watching. Like, comment if you want to. Subscribe if you have not. You can even turn on the notification bell. Appreciate it. Thank you for tapping in. And keep on watching. Turn me up, y'all. Turn me up because I'm going up. Don't sleep. Don't sleep. But thank y'all for watching. See you at the next video. Bye.